Good morning, caregivers. I'm Carol, your internationally certified dementia practitioner, here to help you on your caregiving journey. That's my goal. It really is. And I'm glad that you've chosen to join me here today for Let's Talk Dementia live on Facebook. A special thanks to our sponsors who help finance the ministries of Let's Talk Dementia as we help people really in, 75 countries. Pretty cool, huh? And the first one would be HD Imports, located on Flint Street Extension in Rock Hill, South Carolina, 803-985-0985. You can contact them and trust them fully for the care, the maintenance, the repair of your Honda, Hyundai, Acura, Toyota, and Kia. A special thanks to Beth Crosby, Editor Beth at editorbeth.com. If you are writing something, then she needs to put her eyeballs on it to make sure what you're producing best represents you. And I thank her for what she is doing and has done for Let's Talk Dementia. And then also, last but not least, Life in the Carolinas, the award-winning, Emmy-nominated, Telly Award-winning television show about what it's like to live in North and South Carolina. You can find them at www.lifeinthecarolinas.com and on YouTube. If you would like to be one of our sponsors that helps with our ministry, sure, we'd love to hear from you. And our email is carol@letstalkdementia.org. Well, I have big news that I'm super excited about that I don't totally understand, but I'm hoping to soon understand. I was contacted recently about having this show on Roku and Amazon Fire Stick. There is an organization that has a senior channel that they are building, and we have been chosen to be part of it. Now, when I more fully understand that, I'll let you know more about it when it's up and running. But each of our shows, Monday through Thursday, will soon be on Roku, so, or Amazon Fire Stick, if you have either one. And if you're sitting around one evening and you miss the show, well, you can just click right over there and find us somewhere, somehow. But it's pretty neat. I'm excited about that. We have viewers in, it's either 4 or 5 countries right now on this Facebook show and on our podcast that is on Spotify and iTunes and our website. We're in 75 countries. So there's a lot of you checking us out, and I'm glad that you are. Speaking of which, today I want to talk to you about being aware of changes in your loved one. Maybe little changes. It's going to be hard to ignore big changes. I'm going to tell you, I was talking with a lady who called me last night, and it was a wonderful conversation. And Hope, if you're watching, I enjoyed speaking with you, and I admire what Hope's doing. She's taking care of her grandmother. She's taken upon herself the responsibility of moving in with Grandma, and not just being there, but being very proactive and doing the best that she can do for her grandmother. She's read my book, and she's smart. She's very smart, and she calls me to ask questions, and I appreciate that. She includes me in her journey, and I'm happy to do that for you. But what we were talking about was she began to notice some changes in Grandma that took place rather quickly. And what I can tell you is with Alzheimer's type dementia, every once in a while you will see this huge decline. It does happen that we just seem to go off the edge and decline greatly. We don't see that all the time. Whoa, the animals are not happy all of a sudden. We see more of a steady decline. Okay, my husband's out there going, shh, 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 trying to get the dogs to shut up. We are dog sitting for our grandson, so you get two of them, who knows. But anyway, what we normally see is either a plateau for a while and potentially a big drop, or more often a plateau and then just this steady little decline. Might plateau again, decline some more. But she was seeing, Hope was seeing, quick declines in her grandmother in succession. I'm not so sure that would be the dementia that we're seeing or the cause of the dementia, but probably a side effect. We've got something going on, like maybe a urinary tract infection or constipation or being thirsty. So I told her, you know, you've got to be very aware of those things. Now, you know that in yourself. Well, you should, because I'm always concerned about caregivers taking care of themselves too. That is why we are holding our first ever Vera's Caregivers Retreat in October in Clover, South Carolina, because 40% of caregivers pass away before their loved one with dementia. That's just crazy junk right there. We can't be having that, y'all. We got to take care of you, the caregiver, and I want to help you with that. But you need to be aware of changes in your loved one and changes in yourself. And sometimes they're little changes and we ignore them. Maybe you should not ignore them. No, I don't think you should run to the doctor every time your nose runs, or every time you get a headache, or every time you get a wart, a pimple. No, but when you start noticing several days in a row with this is going on and that's not just quite right, let's sit down and think about it. So let me give you an example of that in my world. Well, I told you a few days ago about this wonderful product, Cementica Puffy Eye Treatment Green Tea Extract, to get rid of the bags under your eyes. Girlfriend, this stuff works like nobody's business. I mean, you just are gorgeous within 5 minutes. I am not kidding you. I don't make a dime telling you this, although I should. It just takes all the bags away from underneath your eyes. I'm so excited because I got a little bit baggy up here. Gotta pull it tight so I don't have it. Well, I used it the first day. I was so excited. Didn't think too much about things throughout the day. Used it the second day. Still very excited because it works every day. I'll just tell you that. But second day, I had a little bit of a headache. Well, the ladies in my family are prone to migraines. It's something that goes back generations for us females. I tell folks, you might inherit houses and large amount of cash. I inherited migraines and hot flashes. Thanks, Mama. So having a headache's not all that unusual for me, although I have gotten them under control by taking one Excedrin prophylactically, I like saying that word, every morning. Now, you have to know I'm allergic to caffeine. I don't drink caffeine, I don't consume caffeine, except one Excedrin. And Excedrin has caffeine, but it's just the right amount of caffeine to prevent a migraine, and more than that, causes a migraine. All kinds of studies that's very true in a lot of people. I'm not that odd, although I know you think I am. But believe me, there are other people with the same issue. So anyway, day two, had a little bit of a headache. Day three, more of a headache. Day four, more of a headache. By yesterday, I had a knock me down. I think I'm going to throw up. Please leave me alone. I got to lay in the chair and get rid of this blame headache. Well, as of right now, it still hurts just a little bit right here, because if you've ever had a migraine, you know you have migraine hangover. Now, I've never been drunk in my life, although I had a margarita one time at a Mexican restaurant. I don't know what I said and what I did, but my son-in-law said, we got to take your mama back and get her another margarita. She was a lot of fun. So, I don't drink no margaritas no more. But anyway, hangovers from drinking margaritas, I am told, are very real. But you can have migraine hangovers where you just don't feel good. And you know that if you move your head just right, it's going to start hurting. And that's where I am right now. Yesterday, I'm going, what is causing these blame headaches? I haven't been doing this for years. I mean, this has just been gone. It's not been part of my world. Then I thought, what have I changed? What have I added to my daily regimen or my daily intake of food that hadn't been there before? And it was this. Has green tea in it. Green tea has caffeine. And that was just enough caffeine to set me over the edge. Now, you got to know, when you unscrew this, see the end of that? You are getting just enough to come out the end of that to put on underneath your eyes. This is minute dang amount, one here and one there. How in the world did that get me? I can't tell you, but it did. But I can also tell you that minute amount gets rid of bags, so it obviously is pretty potent. So for me, can't continue using it, which I am very disappointed about. But being aware of changes and not just letting it go and dealing with pain or dealing with discomfort, stop and think about, what did you do differently? What did your loved one with dementia do differently? Did we add a new medication? Did we add a new food? Did we add a new supplement? Did we take them somewhere that just didn't fit in with their mental or cognitive station in life? Did we put them in a challenging situation that they should not have been in? Think about that. Don't automatically think medication. That's not what you need to do. Hold on, I gotta do something. There you go. And it may be something eventually you do need to do, but not right off the bat. Let's think about, what did we change in life that we need to go back and unchange? And for me, it, unfortunately, it was going back to having baggy dang eyes. Oh, my word. Well, That's my story for today. I thought it was interesting. I thought it was sad. My little sister, bless her sweetheart, sent me a picture of her eyes before and after yesterday. Huge difference. And I'm happy for her. And I'm so jealous because now she's not going to have bags and I am. And you don't want the people in your family to look better than you. Don't you know that's true? Oh my goodness. I'll just get me some dark colored glasses here and y'all won't be able to see it. Well, a special thanks to our sponsors who finance our ministry, and we thank them very much. HD Imports, that are there to maintain your Honda, Hyundai, Acura, and Toyota, and Kia. And you can reach them at 803-985-0985. Life in the Carolinas at www.lifeinthecarolinas.com. And my friend Beth Crosby, Editor Beth at editorbeth.com. I hope you will reach out to these folks. I'm going to keep you posted on this going on Roku and Amazon Fire Stick. And the more I learn about it, the more I can share with you because it's still in the process. But isn't that just cool? Anything we can do to get more dementia education out there. Contact me, Carol, at letstalkdementia.org. And if you want a phone call back, just send me your phone number and I will call you. We'll just have a little confab. Oh, yes, we will. Hope you have a good weekend. Love up on your LO. Let them love up on you and smile at the world. My mama says smile and the world smiles with you. Frown and you frown alone. I miss her. Y'all take care. Bye. See you Monday.